from April 14th through April 26th. The question around campus is, what is the QEP voting? And we're going to tell you exactly what it is. Let's interview some students to find out. Yes. Excuse me. Can you tell me what the QEP voting is?
Isn't that like A squared plus B squared equals C squared?
Yeah, like 3.14.
Yeah.
Not quite. Let's ask some more, see if anyone else knows. Yes, here we go. Excuse me. Can you tell me what the QEP is?
Can I Google it real quick?
True.
Okay, it says that it is a stock thing for like Yahoo at Boca Raton or something.
Boca Raton.
Yeah, that. Is that right?
I think your Google may have messed up there. It's okay. We'll ask some more. Here we are. Yes. Can you tell us what the QEP voting is?
QEP? You talking about my Uncle Quintavious Eugene Pierce? No.
Not quite. The QEP is a specific topic that enhances student learning here at ICC, and it also helps in the accreditation process. So don't forget, on April 14th and 26th, to vote online at your ICC email. That's all for today, folks. Stay chopping, ICC.
Change things up a bit, and we're going to go ahead and get started with our first contestant. So please welcome to the stage singing Vanessa Carlton's 1,000 Miles, Sadie Moss.
It's always times like these we think of you.
wonder if you ever think of me. Cause everything's so wrong, don't belong, drowning in your precious memories. And I need you, and I miss you, and now I wonder if I could fall.
Maybe just a little bit pitchy, but you are so comfortable on that stage. And I think everybody had a really good time watching and listening to you. So a little pitchy, probably not your fault. Good job.
Thank you.
Awesome. Hey, Miss Sadie, how you doing?
I'm good.
Hey, that was good. Good. That was good, and you got the audience involved right away. I gave you really high marks on that. And you look like you're having fun, right? You're having a good time up there.
Yeah.
And the audience had a good time, right? Were y'all having a good time? All right, that's good. Yeah, you did great. That's a great way to start the show, following the fresh Prince of Bel-Air. That's good. Thank you.
Hey, Sadie, I think you did a really good job. The only tip I might give is when you're moving and dancing, be sure to hold that mic just in front of your face, because there was a couple of times where we couldn't hear fully. But overall, it's a great performance, and I really liked how you got the crowd involved. So overall, good job.
Thank you.
Hey, Sadie, I got to see the performance last week also, and I really think you you improved your confidence level. You came out, and you had really improved that. I liked the audience engagement. That was good. You might want to just keep them going. You know, if they start falling off, go ahead. You did that towards the end, which was good. Keep them going. Keep them into it, and but otherwise, good job.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sadie. Our next contestant, singing I Hope You Dance, a song by Leanne Womack. Please welcome to the stage, Ariel Berger.
Thank you.
Shoes, and I like the song. That's a great song, and you did a great job. Why'd you pick that particular song?
I just wanted something a little different than what I usually do, and I knew that if I did something a little fun, I wasn't really comfortable doing something extra fun yet, so I just chose something a little more calm that I was a little more confident in.
That was great. You did a great job.
That was really good. Like you said, I love the shoes. You did a really good job. Try to get your confidence up a little. I know it's so tough to come out here and sing in front of everyone, so kudos to you. So the only thing I would kind of critique is build your confidence up, but because you got it. You did really good.
Thank you.
Good job.
Even though it's a slow song, go ahead and stroll around the stage and let every part of the stage, you know, see you and feel, you know, one, makes everybody feel a little more part of the show. So go ahead and move, even though it's a slower song. And don't forget to breathe. Sometimes you have to just take that deep breath and be ready for your big chorus.
I think everybody said everything that I was going to hit. Of course, Allie started out with my favorite thing, which is I love your shoes because they are fabulous. And if I could wear them, I would knock you down and take them off. But it's not an easy thing to do. Get up there and sing that song, and it's such a huge song. You hit those big notes really well, and I think the lower parts maybe kind of threw you a little bit, but past that and those shoes, they saved everything. Good job.
Thank you.
All right, next up, singing Ready for Love, contestant number 3. Contestant number 3, Lakendra Orr.
To be held in your captivity.
ability. I am ready for love. All of the joy and the pain, and all of the time that it takes just to be.
Which was, I expected so much more of you, only because I think that song was so safe for you, and it didn't show what I think you can do. And I'd say that because, oh my gosh, I mean, you made that song fantastic, and it was kind of boring. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so I'm gonna be back next week, so blow me away.
Alrighty, thank you.
Hey, Miss McKendra, how you doing?
I'm fine. How are you?
Good, good. That was a good song. I didn't know the song, but I like the song. That's a good song. It's a tough song to do. I mean, but you did it great. And wow, we hope to see you back next week. That was great.
Thank you.
Hey, Kendra, I have to agree with Kelly. I mean, I heard the first few lines of the song, and your vest is blowing in the wind. I thought, okay, it's gonna get good, and it's gonna pick it up soon. I kept waiting for that pickup and that pickup, and it never came. But I can tell you have a big range, and you can blow us away. So, like Kelly said, next week, just bring it, girl.
Thank you.
Hey, LaKendra. On the chorus and on the payoff at the end, you wowed us. That was great, and that was exactly what we wanted to hear. I agree with them. You know, choose a song next week that you get to do a little more of that. And thank you very much.
Thank you.
Next up, we have contestant number 4, Georgia Connor, singing Walk Away. Thank you.
Kelly Clarkson, because she's kind of one of those what I call scream singers who can just scream and it just gets old. But you did a really good job of controlling that, and there was some up and downs in there that you really hit well, you hit the notes well, and your pitch stayed pretty consistent throughout the whole thing. So I think good job.
Okay, thank you.
You did a really good job this week of milking every note, and you took your opportunities to really let loose, and that was a really good performance.
Thank you.
Awesome song choice. Absolutely fantastic. I hope the kids are listening right now, because you picked a song that showed everything that you can do, and you did it great. So,
thank you.
Good job.
Thank you.
That was great. I love the outfit. You know, appearance, I think, when you're doing stuff like this is like 50 or 60% of the deal. So that was really great. A great song. I had heard the song a few times, but I really liked it. Lots of ups and downs with the pitch in it. It was really good. Just keep it up.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. And contestant number 5 is next, singing Born to Fly by Sarah Evans, Jordan Wade.
Thank you.
Jordan, that was a great job. And it's interesting to see how much more confident you are this week than last week. You walked out like you really just on the stage, and sit down at the end was very nice. It just brings you closer to the audience. It just you acted like you owned that song. Very good job.
Thank you.
Hey, Miss Jordan, that was really good. I don't know how you did last week, but you did great this week. You looked like you were having fun, right? You were having some fun up there.
Yes,
you look confident. And, you know, when you, like you said, when you sit down on the stage here, it gets you more connected with the audience. And sometimes, you know, it's like the audience is sitting out here and y'all are up there. But that was great. You did a great job. Looked great. It just looked like you were having a great time. And the audience loved it, you could tell.
Thank you.
Hey. Okay, so I have heard people sing that song so many times, and I think you are the best version I've ever heard.
Thank you so much.
You were fantastic. And has anybody ever told you you look like Joanna Gaines from Fixer Upper?
No.
Okay. She does, doesn't she? Maybe it's just the old people that know that show. Sorry.
She just called me old.
Jordan, I don't know what's left to say that hasn't been said, but you did a really, really good job. Like they said, getting on the steps, getting off the stage, kind of getting into the crowd, that was really good. It's really good use of the stage and the area around you. So you really own that song, and you did a good job.
Thank you.
Up next, contestant number 6, singing Superstar, De Beyonce Ties.
Baby. Deviante. Did I say that right?
Yes, sir.
Awesome. You look great. You got the red shoes. You got the red bow tie. Great outfit. That was an awesome performance. The audience loved it, and I can't think it of anything to criticize. You did great. That was awesome.
Thank you.
Do you know who Karen Carpenter is?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So, obviously, you're doing the Luther version, but I loved how you made it yours. It didn't sound like Luther's version. It didn't sound like Karen Carpenter's version, which you really should YouTube that because she was amazing. But you just did, I loved it. It was fantastic. Good job.
Thank you.
And I like your shoes too.
You are just Mr. Stylish, by the way, if you haven't gathered that yet. But great outfit, good song. Confidence, you need to up it a little bit. I know it's a slow song, so it's kind of hard to move around, like I said before, but still try to move around on that stage and make it yours. That's your space, that's your time to perform. But overall, great performance.
Thank you.
You have great tone. I love the way your voice sounds, especially when you hit the note that we're waiting for. You do a very good job with that. You look the part. Just keep up the good work.
Thank you.
Next up, seeing nobody's supposed to be here, by Deborah Cox. Please welcome to the stage, Daviana Pulliam.
Okay, woo girl. When you hear the crowd go that wild when they say your name, that sets the bar pretty high before you even open your mouth, and you met that bar. You did really good. The only thing I kind of have to say, work on your enunciation of the words in your song. Don't just wait to that time where you let go. Make sure you get all those parts in between, because every part of a song is crucial. So that's my one critique for you, but good job.
Thank you.
Daviana, that was just an amazing performance, amazing song. You did a great job with it. For future songs, you might consider not doing one that have the prominent backup singers, because honestly, they can't sing as well as you can.
Thank you.
So you're every time they're singing, you're robbing us of hearing your voice. So think about that for the future.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's true about the backup singers. When I heard them, I thought, well, good grief, they're not as good as her. So that was great. Great song. You've got your own cheering section. You're the only one with signs so far. Right there. That was awesome. You should be on that other show that I think some people are watching tonight. So, yeah, go for bigger and better things. That's awesome. Good stuff.
I forgot to breathe while you were singing. Seriously. And thank God I'm by myself, because I'm going to try and sing just like you on the way home, and it's not going to be anywhere near. Nadi, you are amazing.
Thank you so much.
Are you nervous?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Well, don't be, because you look fabulous. Those shoes are precious, and you have so much more talent than anybody sitting up here. You're fabulous. Good
job.
Thank
you.
Our next contestant is singing Erica Badu's Bag Lady. Put your hands together for Tabitha Foster.
Bag lady.
Tabitha! Hi!
Hi.
Love your skirt. Let me just get this straight. You want her to let it go, let it go, let it go, right? Okay. I'd never heard that song before, but it was actually kind of funky and fun. And you made it funky and fun, so cool.
Yeah, that was good. I'd never heard the song before either. The audience seemed to like it, right? Y'all like that? That was good. That was a great song. It looked like you were very confident in that song. Had you known that song for a long time? Is that one of your favorites or something?
It's not my favorite, but I know it.
Awesome. That was good stuff. You did great.
Tabitha, your confidence really showed through this performance. You did really good. The beginning and the end, you really showed out. You could show what you really could do. So maybe next week, pick a song. This was a fun song. Don't get me wrong. It's a good, funky, fun song. The audience really got into it. But maybe next week, pick a song that goes with your voice, shows what you really can do. But good job.
Tabitha, you have beautiful tone. You can sing. Don't be afraid to let it go yourself a little bit. And I'm not talking about your voice. You did. Your vocal control was excellent. That was a funky beat, and you've got to move a little bit to it. Just take your opportunity. Just move a little bit. You started doing that more towards the end. You got a little more comfortable. But I think it was a nerve situation. But get your nerves under control, and you'll be fine. Great job.
Thank you.
Well, we're over halfway through our contestant list of 14. Next up, number 9, singing wedding song. Welcome, Theo Boyd.
You did a really good job. You've got the look, you've got the confidence. You moved around that entire stage. You made that performance yours. Good job.
Thank you.
Theo, I feel like a concert just broke out. Great job, man. You have the look, you have the voice to go with it. You worked the stage. Just Superb. Great job.
Thank you.
Theo, you were into that song. You had the audience eating out of the palm of your hand that whole time because you were doing it great. Keep on doing that.
Thank you. Thank you.
You are one smart cookie. You know where your talent is, and you know how to get this crowd involved. And, oh, my gosh. I mean, you know, if I ever get married, will you come sing that?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay, good. I mean, don't write anything down, and definitely not in ink, but just in case. Loved it.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, our next contestant is singing one of my favorite songs of all time, Mercy Me's I Can Only Imagine. Please welcome Christopher Montgomery.
By your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I stand in your presence, or in all you keep still? Will I sing hallelujah to my knees? Will I fall? Will I sing for you, Jesus? Will I be able to see it all? I can only imagine, yeah, I can only imagine, oh, surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I stand in your presence, or will I be able to see? Oh, will I sing hallelujah to my knees? Will I fall? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Will I be able to see it? Oh, I can only imagine. Oh, yeah, I can only imagine. Can anybody just imagine being in God's presence? Oh, hey, oh, 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 I want to be able to worship you, yes, in the beauty of holiness, yes. Oh, Lord, you're worthy, yeah, yeah. Lord, you're worthy of the glory, yeah. Oh,
oh my goodness. That was fantastic. I felt like I was in church a little bit. Do you sing that one in church?
Oh, yeah.
Love the shirt.
Yeah, that was great. Everybody knows that song, and I liked what you did with it. You made it your own. It's a great song. Like you said, we can't really imagine what it's going to be like to be in God's presence if we know Jesus. But wow, it's like we had revival in here. That was awesome.
Christopher, I think you did a really good job, and like I've said before, you moved around the stage, you got the crowd involved, you took your opportunities when you could say that one little line in between the verses, and you really found your opportunities to make that song your own. Good job.
You could tell by the way you sang it that you felt that song and that you really liked that song. One thing, the only thing that I could possibly say that might help you, at times it seemed like you got the mic a little too close. It came across just a little bit muffled. But beyond that, it's great performance.
Our next contestant singing You've Got a Friend in Me by Randy Newman, John Ray.
Thank you. friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old pal said. Jane, you've got a friend in me. 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 You got troubles and I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, we can see it through. Oh, you've got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me. Some of the people might be a little bit smarter than I am, bigger and stronger too. None of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy. And as the years go by, our friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's a destiny. You got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me.
John, you did a great job picking a song that everybody has heard, especially anyone with children from Toy Story. So some of us have heard that song more than we'd like to talk about. But you did a great job picking a good song, and it's right in your mid-range. I don't know that it really challenged you, but it's a good song for your voice.
Thank you.
I love the shirt that you're wearing under the plaid. That's fantastic. So, is like Toy Story your favorite movie?
It was my favorite children's movie, yes ma'am.
Yeah. Well, I loved the song. It's refreshing and new, and the shirt just makes it. Good job.
Thank you.
Yeah, hey, I thought you were going to like unbutton the shirt and show us the Toy Story shirt there. It's still one of my favorite movies. I mean, even though, you know, I'm a little bit older than when we used to watch it with our kids. But it's a great song. You may not be like the best vocalist of the group, but it was the funnest song so far of the evening. I loved it.
Thank you.
John, you just seemed comfortable up there. You seemed relaxed. You're probably the most relaxed contestant we've had of the night. You just seemed like you were chilling and singing, and it was great. Came across great, your stage presence is great. Good job.
Thank you very much. Well, our next contestant is performing Adele's version of the Bob Dylan song, Make You Feel My Love. Meg Higginbottom.
ICC.
No.
crawling down the avenue. No, there's nothing that I wouldn't do to make you feel my love. The storms are raging on the rolling sea and on the highway of regret.
Megan, there, you have a purity of voice just right there in the mid-level of your voice that is gorgeous. It's really pretty, and you went through that song very, very smoothly. I'm glad that you sounded more like Adele than you did Bob Dylan.
Thank you.
I'm glad you went that route with it. But you did a really good job with the song, and I look forward to hearing it.
Thank you. Megan, you did a great job. Adele is like up here. I mean, you can't really meet Adele, and you did a great job of meeting that. I mean,
thank you.
When I heard Adele, I thought, oh God, no. But you did a really good job. I mean, there's parts where you could have went up and you might not have hit it, so you stayed where you knew you could be there and you could hit that note and you could sound great, and you did it. You did really good. It was even throughout the whole song. It was a great job.
Thank you.
You know, I think you are another one of those singers who knows what you do and does it well. That song, it just flowed out of you. It didn't look like it took any effort at all. You just opened your mouth and it came out. Beautiful.
Thank you.
Yeah, smooth like silk. I don't know. That's just the first thing that came to mind. I'm not a big fan of Adele, and I know a lot of people are probably think that's crazy, but that was a great song. Bob Dylan is a great songwriter,
mm-hmm,
and that was just a pretty song. You did a great job. Keep it up.
Thank you.
Next up, singing Fallen by Alicia Keys, Alexis Collier.
Ooh.
But did y'all really like that? Come on. That was great. Alicia Keys, wow. In That Girl on Fire, in the song, doesn't she do that one? That was a great song. You looked like you were having a fun time with that song. You looked comfortable with it. Just, that was awesome.
Thank you. I've never seen somebody sing like that and just be so effortless. Just like the girl before you. She stood up there and she sang, but holy cow! I forgot to breathe while you were singing too. That was showing out. That was really stepping up, and you will be here next week. And that's it. Thank you.
Yeah, I said it earlier, when the crowd goes crazy like that, when they say your name, the bar's up there, and you met that bar too. You did really good. It's just like, I have to agree with Kelly. I mean, you just looked like you were talking up there, and you were hitting some serious notes. So good job. Good job.
Thank you.
You first impressed me when you started off with the acapella, and then the song ended, the music ended, and never let a lack of music stop a good song. So you kept going, and the acapella at the end sealed the deal. Great deal. Great job.
Well, contestant number 15 will be singing the song by Nora Jones, Don't Know Why. Please welcome Mark Robbins.
Till I saw the sun, I don't know why I didn't come. I left you by a house of fun. I don't know why I didn't come. I don't know why I didn't come. When I saw them break, I wish that I could fly away. Stand kneeling in the sand, catching teardrops in my hand. My heart is filled with wine, but you.
just witnessed the fact that Frank Sinatra and Nora Jones had a baby, and and his name is Mark Robbins. You did a good job. I would never accuse you of not having a good time while you're up there. You owned the stage and you worked it and made the most out of your opportunity.
Well, Mr. Mark, you get kudos to you for the most daring song selection, because when I saw Don't Know Why by Nora Jones and Mark Robbins, I thought, well, that's going to be interesting. And it was. I mean, you made the song your own, and it was very memorable.
I think you definitely took the biggest risk, and you made it a lot of fun. So thanks for not making it boring.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that completes our contestants for the night. As we did last week, we're testing out our voting system, so we'd remind you to only vote once by texting to this number and use the number of your contestant when you vote to that number. Well, tonight, during our intermission, we're in for a treat. No stranger to the stage, this artist has performed at Libertyland, at High Mass, at Notre Dame's Cathedral in Paris, and as backup singer for recording artist Paul Thorne. Please welcome to the stage ICC's own Candace Fitz.
Thank y'all. I work in the Advising Center, Student Affairs, upstairs in the Student Services building. So all the little flyers and things you've seen about seeing your advisor and all that, that's us that put that stuff out. With the theme tonight of, 95 to 05, I picked Mary Mary's Shackles. And so listen to me now. We're going to go to church for a minute. I need some help singing this. If you know it, I want you to sing with me. I want you to throw your hands up. I want you to praise them. Okay? Come on.
I just wanna praise you. I just wanna praise you. You broke the chains, now I can lift my hands. And I'm gonna praise you. I'm gonna praise you. In the corners of my mind, I just can't seem to find a reason to believe that I can break free. Cause you see, I have been down for so long, feel like all hope is gone. But as I lift my hands, I understand that I should praise you through my circumstance. So I can dance. Just wanna praise you. Just wanna praise you. I can lift my hands. Ooh, everything that could go wrong, all went wrong at one time. So much pressure fell on me, I thought I was gonna lose my mind. But I know you wanna see if I will hold on through these trials. But I need you to lift this load, cause I can't take it no more. Take them off, take them off. I just wanna praise.
This song is for John John.
I'm not waiting around for the judges to judge me. Bye.
One more time for Miss Candace Fitz. Well, while I'm awaiting our results, I'd like to introduce some special people tonight that have given up their evening to help us out. Our judges. Our first judge is Allie Martin. Mr. Allie is from Tupelo. He's the bureau chief for WCBI-TV. He and his wife, Robin, have three daughters, Ashley, Alexa, and Alyssa, who graduated from ICC and now works for WCBI. Allie and his family have called Tupelo home for 22 years. They attend West Jackson Street Baptist Church, where Allie is an active member of the Children's Church and Media Ministry. Allie has judged Indian Idol before and has looked forward to seeing tonight's talent on the stage. Allie Martin, ladies and gentlemen. Our next judge is Lauren Ann Cobb. She was a 2009 graduate of North Pontotoc High School. After high school, Lauren attended ICC and received an Associate of Arts degree in 2011. During her time at ICC, Lauren Ann was an active member of Indian Delegation, an orientation leader, Who's Who among America's community college students, and served as a drum major of the ICC All-American Band for the 2009 and 2010 seasons. She was also elected ICC's 2010 Homecoming Queen, and later that same year placed top five in ICC's Most Beautiful pageant. Lauren Ann had the honor to hold the title of Miss Pontotoc County Hospitality and went on to win Most Photogenic at the Miss Hospitality State Pageant in Hattiesburg, Mississippi. Lauren Ann continued her education at the University of Mississippi, where she later graduated with honors, earning a bachelor's degree in broadcast journalism. Upon graduation, Lauren Ann accepted a job at WTVA-WLOV as the Assistant Director of Promotions and Community Relations. During her tenure at WTVA and WLOV, she had the opportunity to travel to Los Angeles and tour the Fox production lot and meet various celebrities such as Zooey Deschanel, Andy Samberg, and Seth Green, to name a few. Lauren Ann now works for the Mississippi Public Service Commission as a public relations coordinator and executive assistant for Commissioner Brandon Presley, where she is responsible for social media, weekly press releases, coordinating press conferences, and attending various community outreach programs. Lauren Ann currently resides in Tupelo with her newlywed husband, Seth, and their four-legged child, Gemma. Ladies and gentlemen, Lauren Ann Cobb. Our third judge is Brian Quinn. Mr. Quinn graduated from Ole Miss in 1997 with a degree in English. He completed his master's classwork in 99 from Mississippi College. He has worked for Complete Home Care since August of 2002. He and his wife, Emily, opened Culture Cow Yogurt and Coffee, both in Fulton and in Amory, in 2014. He started writing poetry over 25 years ago and started songwriting in 2010. He has written and co-written hundreds of lyrics and completed around 20 songs. Brian is very involved in community events and helped start Pickin' in the Park, which is a bi-weekly event in Fulton's Play Garden Park, that showcases local talent. He is the current Itawamba First President and former ICDC and Rotary. He is also involved with the Fulton Chamber, Fulton Community Volunteers, and Mantashi Clinic Board Chair. He was a member of the Itawamba Speculative Committee, which brought Toyota Bashuku to Itawamba County. Mr. Quinn is married to Emily Quinn, and they have two children, Dylan, age 12, and Presley, age 8. Brian Quinn. Our final judge is Kelly Carlson. Ms. Carlson is originally from Starkville, Mississippi, but now resides in Tupelo. She is an alumni of Mississippi State University and has been an on-air radio personality for over 25 years. For those trying to figure out her age, she was just 2 years old when she started radio. She is currently the co-host of your hometown morning show on Wizard 106. Kelly has been co-hosting on Wizard for over 18 years and loves her job. She's mother to two sassy four-legged girls, Stella and Millie, and a proud aunt to Kaylee and Cora Yieldy. Ladies and gentlemen, Kelly Carlson. And I'd like to, at this time, welcome out our top 14 contestants to the stage. And just as a reminder, if you would, please be respectful to all of our contestants. They've done such a great job, and each week they have to learn the lyrics to a song and be ready to perform it in 7 days. So that's one more hand for all of our contestants. And now for your top 10. Mark Robbins. Georgia Kate Connor. Jordan Wade. Deviante Ties. Daviana Puyo. Tabitha Foster. Theo Boyd. John Ray. Meg Higginbottom. Ladies and gentlemen, our last contestant in your top 10 also was the most popular, so they received the most text messages. Your top 10 also includes Alexis Carr. Please join us next week for Indian Isle as we decide your top 10. You are dismissed.